Like the Warner Brothers themselves, filmmaker Jon M. Chu is the child of immigrants.
My parents, when they came to America, they didn't know a word of English. The only things they knew were Beatles lyrics and Elvis lyrics. They started a Chinese restaurant in the Bay Area in 1969. It's still there to this day. And I was always surrounded by stories. I would be doing my homework by the bar, folding napkins, and people would come in and they'd tell stories to my parents. That was the connection, food and story.
So, what about us taking an adventure east?
Like Queens?
Like Singapore.
Honoring his family's culture, as well as that of their adopted country, Chu discovered the magic of American motion pictures at an early age.
We would always go to the movies together. It was very much a family event to go to the movies, to go to the local theater and watch that new big movie, whether it was Goonies or Batman. It always gave us joy.
The joy he experienced watching movies kindled in Chu a desire to become a filmmaker himself. But as an Asian American yearning to work in mainstream Hollywood, this amounted to a leap of faith.
Never seen anyone who looked like me be the director. I'm glad I was a bit naive to all of that, and my parents were very supportive of studying film because they loved movies so much.
Film school gave Chu his first opportunity to explore a topic that would become a mainstay in his career, the struggle for cultural identity.
I wrote this piece called Guailo, which means white devil, which is what they called me when I went to Hong Kong to visit for the first time at 16 years old, where I felt like I wasn't a part of that world either, and so lost in between these two cultures.
Overcoming the odds, Chu became a successful Hollywood filmmaker, directing a variety of mainstream movies.
And then I realized, well, why am I doing this movie in particular? Anyone could make this movie. What's a movie that only I could make? And so that's when I found Crazy Rich Asians.
What about the ama? She hate your face too?
She just thinks you're some unrefined banana. Yellow on the outside, white on the inside.
At the center of it is what touched me was the story about Rachel Chu, who's an Asian American going to Asia for the first time. That's exactly my experience of going to Hong Kong and how she was treated and how she had to find her way of, I always call it like the dragon that rises within, where you suddenly become proud of all the things you are, no matter what everybody else says. I know how to tell that story.
If Nick chose me, he would lose his family. And if he chose his family, he might spend the rest of his life resenting you.
And on top of it, you have all the sugary stuff about that world that maybe people haven't been to, Singapore.
Issues of cultural identity are central to Chu's next film as well, a collaboration with legendary writer and performer Lin-Manuel Miranda.
The whole conceit of In the Heights was it's this father telling a story to his daughter, the story of this bodega.
Once upon a time, in a faraway land called Nueva York, it's a story of a block that was disappearing.
And at first we think this bodega is this beach, this escape. But when he tells the story, the bodega slowly becomes the bodega. Very much like the restaurant in my life. When I look back, it's so precious because it's the restaurant. The candle that's been there for 50 years had story.
And I built my little dream, my sueñito, here in Washington Heights. Say it so it doesn't disappear.
Though they come from different backgrounds, these two children of immigrants found a common voice and a shared vision for In the Heights.
I knew that I could help my friend Lin-Manuel Miranda tell this story of his neighborhood that I recognize in myself with this new generation with all hopes and dreams and all trying to figure out how to bring their cultural identity to the next chapter and having different answers and sometimes disagreeing on what that would be.
As a filmmaker, Jon M. Chu's unique talents will enrich American movies for years to come, his voice firmly rooted in stories of cultural identity and family.
And now I have kids. I have a 4-year-old, a 2-year-old, and 10-month-old. And I realize the greatest story I'm ever going to be telling is the story of the world to my kids.